I'm starting to feel like I'm in the middle of a reality show, which is not how the government, senators, or presidents are supposed to make you feel. Although I guess that's what Donald Trump is good at. And I have a feeling it's going to be like this until January 20th, when Trump is removed from the White House and President Joe Biden takes over. But here we are, a week after the election was called, and we have Kayleigh McEnany, who's speaking now both as Trump's campaign advisor and the White House press secretary, which I don't think is possible, but she's doing it anyways, and she has taken the term delusional to the next level.
And Trump believes he will be President Trump, have a second term, and litigation is the first step, many steps away from that.
It would look pretty bad if he did not attend the inauguration. It would sound like, well, look like sour grapes, wouldn't it?
I think the president will attend his own inauguration. He would have to be there, in fact.
Wow, so I don't even think she's playing a card here. I'm convinced they fully believe that Trump won. Either way, they're wrong. It's misinformation. And the worst part is, I'm paying for her salary with my tax dollars, so that she can lie to my face every single day. And she's not alone. We have the one and only Ted Cruz spewing off the same false narrative that Rudy Giuliani was talking about at the Four Seasons Total Landscaping, attacking and undermining the media with his bib and his blanket on, claiming that the media doesn't call elections.
Your reaction, Senator Cruz?
Well, look, it's not surprising that the mainstream media has a partisan bias, and Chris Wallace is one of the worst, as we saw in the debate that he moderated, where he might as well have put on a big foam finger saying Joe Biden number one. I mean, it was his biases that have been there for a long time, but so has the entirety of the mainstream media. The mainstream media was always bad, but with the election of Donald Trump, they got exponentially worse. I think Trump broke the media. The relevant point here is the media don't get to decide the presidency of the United States. That's the voters. The American people get to decide that.
Now, we know the American people did decide this election, and the media just reported the votes that were counted, but just to really show you how hypocritical every single Republican is, the media called Alaska for Trump without having all of the votes fully counted, and they celebrate. The president's daughter, gloating on Twitter about it. So if the media calls a state for Trump, they cheer, and if they call it for Biden, it's rigged. Gee, it's no wonder why Trump has lost every single court case. Now, in the middle of my frustration after watching GOP member after GOP member spit in the face of democracy, we finally get a cathartic and powerful smackdown on Donald Trump when General Mark Milley took the podium this week. Take a listen.
We are unique among militaries. We do not take an oath to a king or a queen, a tyrant or a dictator. We do not take an oath to an individual. No, we do not take an oath to a country, a tribe, or a religion. We take an oath to the Constitution.
Yes, I love that. For more reasons than one, this just gives us confirmation that when and if Trump doesn't decide to leave the White House on January 20th and claims a rigged election, well, we now know his rear end is going to be dragged out by these badass generals, and that will be a glorious moment in America. But until we get to that moment, we are still in the middle of a pandemic where cases and deaths are spiking, which is why I was blown away when Rand Paul took his psychotic coronavirus theories and put them out on full display in a very dangerous fashion for the country to hear. No intro necessary. Here is America's least favorite senator disagreeing with science.
But the other thing is we have 11 million people in our country who have already had COVID. We should tell them to celebrate. We should tell them to throw away their masks, go to restaurants, live again, because these people are now immune. But Dr. Fauci doesn't want to admit to any of that. Dr. Fauci's like, oh, woe is me, until the election occurs, and now maybe he'll be changing his attitude. But the bottom line is there's a great deal of optimism that we should have out there, not just with the vaccine, but with the immunity that kids may have pre-existing, and with the immunity that 11 million people got from having the disease.
No, Rand, it is not a good idea for millions of people to go out celebrating beating coronavirus temporarily, because we do know it can come back again. Not everybody's immune, that's a lie. But again, if you're someone who takes your medical advice from someone like Rand Paul, God help you. And it just gets even crazier. We have the California Congressman Kevin McCarthy again not acknowledging Biden's victory.
Recount going in Georgia. Every recount needs to be finished. You got challenges inside courts. Every challenge needs to be heard. Regardless of who you support in this election, at the end of the day, we want America to be united. Regardless of how this outcome is, You want to be able to trust the election. If there was something that was wrong in this election, we do not want to repeat it for the future either. That's a close race. We had a close race in the last presidential. Let's let all of them carry out, and yeah, some of them could switch.
Another defiant Republican refusing to accept the results of the election. And I just like showing these to you guys so you remember these people and their faces. When it's time for their re-election, remember who fought so hard to destroy our democracy. But nobody's doing that more than the president himself, whose campaign has a voter fraud hotline, which was just removed actually due to being overloaded with prank calls. But seriously, they have a fund called the Election Defense Fund, where they're asking Trump supporters to donate money that will be used for the Trump team to battle this election in court. Here's the twist. According to Reuters, donations under $8,000, which is going to be every single donation from a Trump supporter who isn't a mega wealthy donor, if you're giving them less than $8,000, these donations are split between the Republican National Committee and the Save America Political Action Committee, a super PAC that goes, you guessed it, directly to Donald Trump. So what a brilliant way to cap off the biggest presidential failure in American history than to have the very president himself grift and steal money from his supporters on his way out the door. Honestly, this part I kind of enjoy. Anybody who's donating to him is a complete sucker and deserves to lose all of their money. But boy, this con man Trump knows how to exit with style. There you have it, guys. It's been a crazy week in Trump Town. And if you think things are wild now, just remember, we still have 2 more months left of his presidency. And you know I'm going to be covering everything from all angles. So make sure you subscribe for daily videos, and I will continue to uncover the truth.